Hey, hello, family and friends. This is Pastor Rob from Community, and this is our daily Bible reading. Glad you've logged on. And if you don't get these in your inbox every day, you can if you go to findcommunity.com/Bible reading. So I'm glad we can connect today. Here we are getting closer to the end of November. And this coming Sunday is the 22nd. I'll be speaking. I'm going to finish the series on the King's Cross and look at the climax of how the resurrected Jesus leads us into the world, leads us into mission. It shapes our future. And so these themes of the abundant life that we find in Jesus, the hope we find in Jesus, is actually what leads us forward in life and in Jesus. Now, the theme of our life in God and the call to the mission of Jesus is not new in the New Testament. And so I want to read today from Psalm 98. So that's our passage for today, and I'm going to read the whole psalm. It's 9 verses, and listen to the theme of what God is doing and what he's calling us to. So listen to God's word, Psalm 98. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made his salvation known and revealed his righteousness to the nations. He has remembered his love and his faithfulness to Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with a harp. With a harp and the sound of singing. With trumpets and the blasts of the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord, the King. Let the sea resound and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. Let the rivers clap their hands, let the mountains sing together for joy. Let them sing before the Lord, for he comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world in righteousness and the peoples with equity. Amen. Well, you probably noticed that there's a lot of call to singing and rejoicing, and I'll get back to that. But what's the real basis of it? He talks about the salvation of God. So when we read our scriptures, or if you're having a time to study the Bible, it's always good to look for words that repeat themselves. And so 3 times it talks about salvation that God has worked, the salvation of our God, the salvation that's now made known. And salvation really speaks to, of course, what the rest of the Bible teaches, that we are in need of being saved because of our sin, because of rebellion, because of walking away from God. So salvation is a beautiful word. It speaks of being rescued, of being brought back into safety, into oneness, into fellowship. So we need that, and of course, it's from God. So even back when the Psalms were being written, we don't know which author wrote this Psalm, but it might have been King David. But one of the, you know, here it is like 3,000 years old. And even back then, God's people were aware, salvation of God, salvation is coming, salvation is what we need. So I'm wondering, on that theme today, if you really know of the salvation the Lord has given to you, is that clear in your heart? And usually there's a place where we can consciously remember and consciously say to the Lord with all of our heart and will, Lord, I'm trusting you. I need salvation. I know it comes from you. Now, if you've grown up in the church, sometimes it's hard to recollect that. So again, part of our journey as an adult is to say, I'm in, Lord. I'm with you. I receive this gift of salvation. I hope that's true for your life. In the Bible, as we see the scriptures unfold, we know that salvation then was evidenced through baptism. So I wonder if you've been baptized as a follower of Jesus, not as a baby, but as an actual follower. And I invite you to do that. So you would know that you know that you know that this salvation that scriptures talked about from centuries past and that Christ made provisions for and made available and conquered death and sin is yours. So that's first thing. Do you know salvation? Then secondly, I'm wondering if you'll help us share the word of salvation. Like, are you thinking about anybody who may be far from God? Who are you praying for? Who's maybe one person, one neighbor, one coworker, one relative, one friend? And they're in your heart and they're in your prayers. And by God's grace, hopefully there's place for discussion and dialogue. Maybe there's someone you invite to watch worship service with you, or now come on Sundays. Now we have an outdoor service starting at 10:30 in the courtyard. or to take rooted, to go through and look at the scriptures. So that's our calling. That's our mission. I'll talk about that this coming weekend, that from here to the ends of the earth, and how that shapes our lives, that gives us meaning and purpose and animates us, that others would have a chance to know the grace and goodness of Christ. Now, I'll just leave you with this. When I read this psalm, perhaps you heard all the things of ways to praise God. Creation singing, the rivers clap their hands, the seas resounding. Bring out the musical instruments, all the ones, the harps, the music, the trumpets, the horns. It's a celebration. And that really is a symbol or a sign of what it looks like to have salvation and to know the Lord. That there would be a song in your heart, a time of rejoicing. I hope you have that. I hope you can experience that during the week. Literally, a song in your heart. A shouting to God of thanksgiving, as well as when we gather and worship, whether it be online or in person, that song would be real in your heart. That you wouldn't watch people worship, you'd engage. You would sing to the Lord a new song. Even if you know the song already, it's not technically new, it's new today. It's from your heart because he has done marvelous things. Psalm 98 is a great story, a great message for all of us. So the gift of salvation, do you know it? Are you sharing it? And do you just let your heart rejoice over that? Have a great day, a great week. Look forward to seeing so many of you over the weeks ahead as we regather as one of our worship options on site at 10:30 and then online at 9 a.m. Blessings to you. Take care.